Who doesn't love a good genealogy controversy? A couple weeks ago, I talked about whether Finland was part of Scandinavia, and today I'm going to talk about one that is just as passionate in the amount of comments that we get. Which country has the most redheads? Ireland or Scotland? Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA. Now today's topic is a really fun one, redheads. In past videos, I've consulted a number of different sources whenever talking about redheads and their genetics and populations and how they're distributed in different populations. And I've included some of those links in the description below so that you can look at them. But before we get on with the controversy, let's talk a little bit about the science part of it. There are several SNPs that are linked with red hair, and almost all of them are found on the chromosome 16, the gene MC1R. The three most prominent ones are RS1805007, RS1805008, and RS1805009. Now, this is a recessive gene, so you need two copies of that gene in order to have the red hair expression, which means you got one from both your mother and from your father. If you only got one copy of this gene, then you're just a carrier, and maybe your children can have red hair as long as your spouse also is a carrier of this gene. The majority of redheads throughout the world are concentrated in Northwestern Europe. But redheads can be found all over the world, and a couple of non-Europeans who are reported as redheads are Cleopatra and Genghis Khan. Now, my great-grandfather came from Cornwall, England, which is actually a hotbed for redheads. And my grandfather, when he had hair, he had red hair. Now, I tested my mom, who is not a redhead, but it shows that she is a carrier of this gene at the SNP RS1805007. So then I looked at me and my three brothers. Now, my dad is not a carrier of this gene, so the only way that we could get the gene is if we got it from our mother. Turns out, I don't have that gene, so I'm not a carrier of the redhead gene. But my three brothers all are carriers of that redhead gene. So then I looked at all three of their wives. Now, based on the SNPs that were reported by 23andMe, none of their wives are carriers of this gene. But having looked at some of my nieces and nephews, it actually looks like a couple of them might have red hair. So they may have a copy of the gene that's affected by one of the other SNPs that are tied to red hair. But which country has the most redheads? Now, basically, it's really up in the air. Pretty much all the sources that I looked at point towards Ireland or Scotland and sometimes Wales. And it's noted that Northern Ireland and England all have really high percentages of redheads as well. Unfortunately, none of the sources seem to be looking at all five of those countries or at the same thing whenever they were doing their research. So some research might mention two or three of the countries, but none of the research, all using the same methodology, looks at all five countries, or at least is reported on that. Ireland and Scotland are usually reported with about 10 to 15%, and Wales is sometimes included in that, although usually at a smaller percentage than either Ireland or Scotland. But one thing that is interesting is most of the sources that mentioned it mentioned that Wales actually has the highest percentage of carriers of the redheaded gene. So while Scotland and Ireland may be in the 35 to 36% range of carriers, Wales is around 38 or 39%. Now, England has about 6 to 8% of their population that are redheads. So, since we have a controversy, we decided to go and ask the genealogists. At RootsTech in 2018, we talked to these genealogists.
My name is Amber Larson, and I'm from Ogden, Utah.
Robert Van Dam, and live in Spanish Fork, Utah at the moment.
My name is Guillermo. I'm from Chile.
My name's Kama Zollinger. I currently live in Pleasant Grove, Utah.
I'm Paul Welton. I'm from Lehigh, Utah.
I'm Randy Jones. I live in West Valley here in Utah.
I'm Debbie Alexander, and I'm from West Richland, Washington.
My name is Susan Monson. I'm from Ogden.
My name is Michael Strauss. I live in Spanish Fork, Utah.
Now, we didn't want to prejudice their answers, so all we asked is a simple question. What country has the most redheads?
Oh, stereotypically, we think of like Ireland or Scotland. But statistic-wise, the United States has the highest population, so I think probably the United States.
Would probably guess Ireland or Scotland.
I believe it's somewhere around Ireland.
Which country? The United States.
Ireland.
I would say Scandinavia.
Ireland? Maybe Scotland.
I know what family doesn't have the most redheads. That would be mine, since it runs in my family, and I'm hugely disappointed. I am infatuated with redheads. I'm going to say the United States.
Now, you can see from those interviews that Ireland had more votes than Scotland. However, there was a couple of people that identified the United States as having the most redheads. How could that be? Because Ireland and Scotland have about 10 to 15%, and the U.S. only has about 2 to 4%. Ah, but we're talking about percentages, not actual numbers. Remember, we just asked people which country has the most redheads. Well, it turns out that population does matter. Now, Scotland has more people than Ireland. And so it turns out that Scotland has about 680,000 redheads, while Ireland only has about 614,000 redheads, if they both have roughly the same percentage of redheads. Wales is even smaller, and so it actually has about half as many redheads as Scotland or Ireland does. But then we start to look at other countries, and even though they have much smaller percentages of redheads, because they're much larger countries, they have more redheads. So Australia has more redheads than either Ireland or Scotland. Canada has about twice as many redheads as Ireland and Scotland. England, even though it has half the percentage of redheads, it has about five times as many redheads in the total numbers as Ireland or Scotland. Russia is one place that's proposed of where this redheaded gene actually started, and there's a group of very high concentration of redheads within Russia. But overall, Russia has about 2.5 to 2.8 million redheads, so at least four times the number of redheads as either Ireland or Scotland. And then we get to the United States, which, because it has more than 300 million people, even though there's only about 3% of the population that is redheads, that equals 13 million redheads. It totally dwarfs the number of redheads of Ireland and Scotland. In fact, there's more redheads in the United States than there are people in Scotland and Ireland combined. So the United States wins for having the most redheads. But there's also a couple of little hiccups, because like I said, the redheaded trait can actually be found throughout most of the world. Now, it's really rare outside of Europe and the Middle East, but even in countries like China and India, there is some small percentage of redheads. And because those countries have such a ginormous population, both China and India have about 1 million redheads each, which is more than Scotland or Ireland. So maybe the next time you're thinking of redheads, instead of thinking of the Irish or the Scottish, you should be thinking of the Chinese or the Indians. If you're a redhead from Scotland or Ireland or anywhere else in the world, let us know what you think in the comments below. Connect with us on Twitter at FH Fanatics or on Facebook, Family History Fanatics, where we can interact with you and respond to your comments.